Hi, my name is Patrick Boyle. Welcome to my YouTube channel. So in today's video, we're going to learn about covered calls. And then in tomorrow, we'll do a video on protective puts. And then the next video after that will be on put call parity, which will hopefully pull all of these ideas together. So if you're totally new to options and derivatives, you should probably watch some of my earlier videos that explain what an option is, how they pay off and things like that. Anyhow, on to covered calls. So there are a number of option strategies that involve trading a single option and its underlying asset as a combination. Covered calls are one of those strategies. Many investors who might be long a stock are willing to sell away some of its upside by selling a call option on that stock. And this strategy is known as a covered call. Sometimes in Europe, they refer to it as a buy right. The long position in the underlying instrument is said to provide the cover, as the shares can be delivered to the buyer of the call if the option ends up being exercised. So why might someone do this? Why would you want to sell a covered call? Well, maybe you own a stock and you've owned it for a while and you know you like owning it, it's done all right, but you think it's the kind of stock that's going to go up 5% a year. And you'd like to make a little bit more money. So you decide to sell, we'll say, a 10% out of the money call on that. Now, you're probably, one idea is that, you know, it'll go up 5% in the year, that call option will expire worthless and you'll get to keep all of the premium. Another idea you might have is that maybe if it went up 10%, you'd be happy to sell it anyhow. So rather than putting a sell limit order in the order book, you can sell a call like this and get paid a premium in order to wait for the price to go up 10%. Another thing is, even we'll say, for example, if the price of the underlying falls a little bit, you'd say, well, I'm better off because if I just owned the underlying, I would have lost a certain amount, and I lose a little bit less because I get to keep the option premium on the call option that I sold. So that is a covered call option, or at least that's the idea behind it, or why someone might want to do that. So what does this options position look like when we draw its payoff profile? So as you can see on the screen right here, we've got the payoff of being long the underlying, which is the heavy black line that you see there, and then the call option, the call option that we have sold. So obviously we're receiving that premium, which is good. We're doing probably a little bit better in the lower half of the returns profile than we would have done had we not sold the call option. But as you can see, once it hits the strike price, what's happening is that the amount of money that you're making there on being long the stock is exactly offset by the amount of money that you're losing in being short the call option. So what happens then when we combine these two payoffs together? We end up with a payoff like you can see right now. And if you've watched some of my earlier videos on what option payoffs look like, you should probably notice that this payoff, instead of being a totally new payoff profile, looks an awful lot like being short a put option. And that's because the payoff of being long a stock and selling a call on it is the same, or gives you the same profile as being short a put option. That's kind of an interesting thing. And we'll leave it there for now. Next, you should watch my video on protective puts and then on put call parity, and we'll explain how all of this works and why it's useful. Talk to you later. Have a great day. Bye.